Welcome to AJ Akshar Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss CBSE Class 8, Chapter 16, Light Chapter, NCERT, Textbook, Exercise, Question and Answers. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please share your valuable comments in the comment section. Okay, let us go to the today's session. First one. Suppose you are in a dark room. Can you see objects in the room? Can you see objects outside the room? Explain. Here in this question, they are asking that in a dark room, can you see the objects? No, we can't see the objects in the dark room. But we can see objects outside the room. In case there is light outside the room, so in the presence of light we can see the objects. In the presence of dark room, here in the presence of dark room nothing but no light. So if there is no light, there is no images and there is no objects, we are not seeing any objects in the dark room. In case there is a light outside the room, it is so because to see an object we need light which gets reflected from the object and enters our eyes. So in the presence of light, the reflected from the object and whatever the enters our eyes, so the image falls in the retina, then we can see the objects. So in a dark room, can you see the objects? No, we can't see the objects in the dark room. Can you see the objects outside the room? If there is light, then we can see the objects in the outside of the room. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. Regular reflection and irregular reflection. This is differentiate between regular and diffuse reflection. Does diffuse reflection mean the failure of the loss of reflection? Now we will discuss. Here this table refers the differences between regular reflection and irregular reflection, or another name of irregular reflection is diffused reflection. So in regular reflection occurs smooth surfaces. Irregular reflection occurs on unpolished surfaces and rough surfaces. Here in regular reflection occurs plain, smooth, polished surfaces. In irregular reflection, diffuse reflection occurs on unpolished and rough surfaces. In regular reflection, all the reflector rays are parallel to each other. Here in irregular reflection, reflector rays are not parallel to each other. So does diffuse reflection mean the failure of loss of reflection? No, diffuse reflection does not mean failure of the loss of reflection. It is due to irregularities in the reflecting surface like that of cardboard. So it is not failure of the loss of reflection. Diffuse reflection does not mean failure of the loss of reflection. It is due to irregularities of the reflecting surface like that of the cardboard. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. Mention against each of the following whether regular or diffused reflection will take place when a beam of light strikes. Justify your answer in each and every case. Here in this below the objectives are things which is comes under regular and in which it is irregular reflection will discuss. Polished wooden table, chalk powder, cardboard surface, marble floor with the water spread over it, mirror, piece of paper. Now we'll discuss one by one. First one, polished wooden table. Regular reflection will take place. This is because a polished wooden table will have a plain surface. So regular reflection occurs on polished wooden table. So that's why it comes under regular reflection. Chalk powder, diffuse reflection, because the surface of chalk powder is not smooth. Cardboard surface, diffuse reflection, since cardboard has a rough surface. Diffuse reflection occurs on only rough surfaces. Marble floor with water spread over it. Here it is also regular reflection. Acts, it will act a plane surface. Mirror. Mirror comes under regular reflection because the mirror has a shining surface which is even. A piece of paper. Diffuse reflection because the surface of the paper is rough. So here in this polished wooden table, regular reflection, and the marble floor with water spread over it, regular reflection. Mirror comes under regular reflection. Irregular reflection are chalk powder, cardboard surface, piece of paper. These three comes under regular reflection. And mirror, polished wooden table, marble floor with water spread over it, these three comes under irregular reflection. Regular and irregular reflection. First one, regular reflection. This is comes under regular reflection, and this is irregular reflection, and this is also irregular reflection, and it is regular reflection. This is also regular reflection, and it is irregular reflection. So first one regular, that is polished wooden table and marble floor with water spread over it. This is also comes under regular reflection, and mirror also comes under regular reflection. Piece of paper, cardboard surface, chalk powder comes under irregular reflection. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. State the laws of reflection. Here we are explaining the laws of reflection. There are two laws of reflection. One is angle of reflection is equals to angle of incidence, or angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is denoted by letter I, and angle of reflection is denoted by letter R. So that is angle I is equals to angle R. Next, the incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. This is the second law of reflection. Incident ray, normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. Okay, these are the two laws of reflection. Next, we'll go to the next question. Let us go to the next question. Describe an activity to show that the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal at the point of incidence lie in the same plane. Now I'll discuss. Now here we have to prove that activity, incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal at the point of incidence lie in the same plane. First, we have to take a plane mirror and stand it on a plain sheet of paper with a block. Now we have to draw incident line AB. Now look in the mirror and mark the points on the paper where you feel the line is traveling after getting reflected from the mirror. Remove the mirror and draw a perpendicular line on the mirror line. Join the points to make the reflector ray. You will observe that incident ray, reflector ray, and normal will lie in the same plane, that is on the sheet of paper. Next, see, this is the wooden table and this is a mirror. Here we are taking the sheet of paper and we are drawing the normal, and this is the incident ray. We are incidenting the light ray by the torch, and it is a normal. Normal nothing but a perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence, and it is a reflected ray. Next, see here, this is the plane mirror, and here we are proving that incident ray, normal at the point of incidence, reflected ray, all should lie in the same plane. This is about the second law of reflection. Okay, next, fill in the blanks. First one, a person 1 meter in front of a plane mirror seems to be 2 meters away from his image. If you touch your left ear with your right hand in front of a plane mirror, it will be seen that in the mirror that your right ear is touched with. This is the phenomenon of lateral inversion. left hand become right hand, right hand become left hand. Similarly here, if you touch your left ear in your with your right hand in front of a plain mirror, and it seems in the mirror your right ear is touched with the left hand, left ear with the right hand, and in the image right ear, if you are touching the right ear, so left ear becomes here right ear. The size of the pupil becomes large when you see in the dim light. Night birds have lesser cones than rods in their ears. Okay, next one. The angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Here always, sometimes, under special conditions, never. So here, angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. This is the first law of reflection. So angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. So this is the first law of reflection. Next one. The image formed by a plane mirror is virtual, behind the mirror, and enlarged. Virtual, behind the mirror, and of the same size as the object, and real at the surface of the mirror and enlarged. Last option is real, behind the mirror, and of the same size as the object. So the image formed by a plane mirror is always virtual, behind the mirror, and of the same size of the object. So plane mirror forms a virtual image, and this is the behind the mirror of the same size of the object. So this is the one of the characteristics of the plane mirror formed by the image formed by a plane mirror. So the image formed by a plane mirror is virtual. Okay, thanks for watching this video.